Hello everyone. In the last session, we have seen the truth table and the logic symbol of the different gates like OR gate, AND gate, NOT gate, NAND gate, NOR gate, XOR gate and XNOR gate. And also we have seen the block diagram of how to develop the digital circuit and which are the different techniques used for implementation onto the hardware. In this session, we will see what is the canonical form and how to write the SOP and POS equations in the canonical form. What is a canonical form? Canonical form is the unique representation of the function. There are two canonical representations. One is the canonical sum of products and second one is the canonical product of sums. We have seen what is sum of product and also we have seen what is product of sums. Now, how is the representation in the canonical form? That we are looking in this session. That is canonical sum of products and canonical product of sums. These are the steps to place SOP equation into the canonical form. SOP is sum of product expression. How to convert the simple sum of product expression into the canonical form? There are some steps to be followed. So these are the various steps. First step is identify the missing variable in each AND term. Second step is AND the missing term and its complement with the original AND term. And next step is expand the term by the application of the property of distribution. Let us see the example. So this is the example. Let me share my desktop. The example says, place the following equation into the proper canonical form. Let us try this expression. So let us solve. So what is the solution? So there are three parts, or you can say it as three terms. First is AB bar, the second is AC bar, and the third term is BC. Now what is the first term in the converting? First term in converting is we have to identify the missing variable. So let us start with the first term AB bar. And what are the function variables? The function variables are A, B and C. So here in this term, the missing variable is C. So we have to AND the missing variable and its complement. So here it is AB bar into C plus C bar, or you can say it as C or C bar. Now what is C or C bar? So suppose you assume that if C is equal to 0, then C bar will be is equal to 1. So C or C bar, so 0 or 1 will be is equal to 1. If C is equal to 1, C bar is equal to 0, then you have 1 or 0 is 1. So when we AND C or C bar with any term, the expression remains unchanged. Then we will simplify this. So we can write it as A B bar C or A B bar C bar. This is about the first term. The second term is A C bar. Which is a missing term here? The missing term is B. Then we have AC bar and the missing term and its complement. We get it as ABC bar or AB bar C bar. This is about the second term. The third term is BC. Here the missing element, or you can say it as missing variable, is A. Therefore we have BC. A or A bar, this is equal to ABC or A bar BC. Now we have expanded all the terms. Canonical minterm expression, canonical form in the sense, we should have all the variables. So suppose if the function has ABC, then in each of the term, product term, we should have all the variables. So here we are getting it as AB bar C, AB bar C bar, here A B C bar, A bar, sorry, A B bar C bar, A B C, and here A bar B C. Now if you observe this, the term A B bar C bar, this term, so let me mark that, this term and this term are repeated. As per Boolean algebra, if we have A or A, then the result is A. Similarly, A dot A is also A. Therefore, instead of writing this A bar B bar C bar twice, we should write it as only once into the final expression. We get the final expression as P is equal to A B bar C or A B bar C bar or A B C bar. See, since I cannot write this because it is already written over here, or A B C or A bar B C. This is the canonical form of the given expression. So we will move to the next problem. The next problem is given as B is, that is the second problem, that is B problem. It is given as G is equal to F of W, X, Y, Z. The variables are W, X, Y, Z. There are four variables and the expression given as W bar X or Y, Z bar. So step one is W bar X. W bar X is the product term which has the missing variables as Y and Z. So this has to be ANDed with Y or Y bar and Z or Z bar. So these two are expanded in two stages and we get this as the final expression. So similarly, Y Z bar has the missing terms of W and X. And these are to be ANDed, W or W bar and X or X bar. So this also is expanded in two stages. Then rearranging we get this expression. Therefore the final expression is this one. It is the same step what we have done in the previous problem. The same steps are to be followed. Then we get the final expression. We have seen steps to place SOP equation into the canonical form. Now, what are the steps to place POS equation into the canonical form? First step is identify the missing variable in each OR term, then OR the missing term and its complement with the original OR term, then expand the term by the application of the distributive property. Let us see one example. This is the example given. Place the following equation into the proper canonical form. What is the expression given? T is equal to F of ABC, A or B bar and B or B bar or C. Now we need to place this into the proper canonical form. So consider step by step. The first step is you have to find out which is missing, which variable is missing into the first term. Let us start with the first term, A or B bar. Which variable is missing here? C is missing. Therefore, this has to be ORed with C, C bar or C, C bar. Now expand this. When you expand this, you get it as A or B bar or C and A or B bar or C bar. Similarly, in the second term, B bar C, which is the variable missing? A is the variable missing. Therefore, this has to be ORed with A, A bar. Now, this comes out to be A or B bar or C and A bar or B bar or C. Now we need to write the complete expression, which is the complete product of some expression, that can be written as t is equal to f of abc, that is the function of abc, which can be written as, see now observe the terms. So here we have two terms, here also we have two terms. So you have to find out which terms are repeated, and the terms which are repeated has to be considered only once. So if you observe these two, this term, that is this term and this term are repeated, and this has to be considered only once in the final expression, because as I told you, it is a dot a is also is equal to a, and a or a is also is equal to a. So we have to apply that rule and write the final expression. The final expression is, the final expression will be a or b bar or c, a or b bar or c bar. This is repeated, I need not have to consider. And next one is a bar, b bar, c. This is the final expression which is into the canonical form. And this is product of some expression. Why it is a product of some expression? See, these are the sum expressions, and the product of all these sum expressions is taken, and we have in each of the term all the variables present with respect to the function. Therefore, this is known as the canonical form of the POS, that is product of sum expression. Generation of switching expression from the truth table. See, here you have to remember these two signs. The sigma, sign sigma indicates summation and stands for the sum of product canonical form. Similarly, pi indicates the product of sum canonical form. Remember, sigma indicates sum of product canonical form, whereas pi indicates product of sums canonical form. Let us see one example. This example says, write the canonical min term and max term expression for the following truth table. Canonical min term max term expression, in the sense, or first let us consider how to write the min term expression. Here if you see the truth table, A, B, M and S are the inputs, and this capital M is the output variable. For the min term, canonical min term expression, we need to find out which row contains the output variable as 1. The output as 1. See, for example, 0, 1, 1, 1 contains the output as 1. Here, 1, 0, 1, 1 contains the output as 1, and 1, 1, 1, 1 also has the output as 1. We need to consider all these and write the min terms for this. The min term for this is A bar B M S. Since this is 0, that has to be complemented. So similarly for this, it is A B bar M S. And for this, it is A B M S. Now we have 3 min terms into the truth table because there are 3 ones. Then the canonical min term expression can be written as, it is the sum of all those product terms. So M is equal to F of A, B, M, S, which is all those three, A bar B, M, S plus A, B bar M, S or A, B, M, S. Here this sign indicates it is a logical OR. Similarly for the max term expression, we need to write, let me change the color of the pen, or for the max term expression, we have to consider zeros into the output column. Then go on writing the max terms. The max term for this is A or B or M or S. Then for this A, B, M, S bar, for this A, B, M bar, S. What you have to do is, wherever there is 1, that has to be complemented. Wherever there is 0, that has to be kept as it is. Here, A or B or M bar or S bar. So like this, we need to write the expression for all the zeros which appear onto the output column. For min term, you have to consider ones into the output column, and for max term, you need to consider zeros in the output column. Once we write that, we have to write the final max term expression, and that is given as M is equal to F of ABMS and all these max terms. And this is called as the product of sum expression. See, all these are the sum expressions. So these are the sum expressions, and product of all, that is considered as max term expression, or it is called as the product of sum expression, and this is into the canonical form. What you need to remember here is, for max terms you need to consider zeros and write the expression. For min terms, you need to consider ones in the output column and you have to write the product terms. So these are the sum terms and these are the product terms, and then based on that we write what is the canonical min term expression and what is the canonical max term expression. Let us consider one more example. Express the following SOP equation in min term list. So how do I express this equation into the min term list? See, instead of writing the entire min term, we can list the min terms. So how do we do that? The solution for this is, how many terms are there? A bar, BC, A bar, B bar, C and ABC. Let us consider one by one, A bar, BC. What is a binary form of it? This is 0, 1, 1. This is the representation in binary. What is the equivalent decimal? Equivalent decimal is 3. So similarly, for the next one, A bar, B bar, C. The binary is 0, 0, 1 and equivalent decimal is 1. The last term is A, B, C. The binary is 1, 1, 1 and equivalent decimal is 7. Now what is the min term list? The min term list is, min term list is given as H is equal to the function of, so it contains three variables A, B, C, and I told you min term is represented as sigma and max term expression is represented as pi. Sigma of, if you put in a order, you will get the list as 1, 3 and 7. So this is what is the min term list. Now let us consider one more example. Express the following SOP equation in a minterm list. Here there are 4 variables. In the previous example, it has 3 variables, that is A, B, C, and here the function has 4 variables W, X, Y and Z. And this is the expression given, and we have to find what is a minterm list, W, X, Y, Z bar or W, X bar, Y, Z bar. W bar X, Y, Z bar, W bar X bar, Y, Z bar. We need to find out what is the equivalent decimal number with respect to each of these min terms. Let us solve that. First term is W, X, Y, Z bar. This can be written as 1, 1, 1, 0. This is in binary. Now how do you write into the decimal? See, always you have to consider the weightage as this is 8421. Since 3 ones we have here, The decimal equivalent of this is 8 plus 4 plus 2. That is 14. Similarly, for the next expression, it is W X bar Y Z bar, which is equal to 1010. Again, if you apply this 8421 formula, so we get it as 8 plus 2, that is 10. 10 base 10. Next is W bar X Y Z bar. The equivalent binary is 0110. And we have the decimal value as 10. And last min term given is W bar X bar Y Z bar, which is equal to 0010 binary, and we have the decimal equivalent as 2, because 8421 only 11 is present here. So this is 1, only 11 is present here. We get the equivalent decimal number as 2. Now what is a min term list? Min term list is given as G is equal to F of W X Y Z, which is equal to, again min term I told you, it is represented as sigma. If you write in order, we get it as list 2, 6, 10 and 14. This is what is the min term list of this particular expression. So the same min term list we are using when we go for the K-map. We will try for the POS expression. POS equation. POS equation gives the max term list. Here we have three variables A, B, C, and the expression is given as A or B bar or C, A or B bar or C bar, and A bar or B bar or C. We will write the expression or max term list. Let us solve this. These are the max terms. So the first max term is A or B bar or C. We have the equivalent expression or equivalent binary as 0, 1, 0. This is binary. See, whenever there is bar, that will become 1. So here B has the complement, so that is 1. Whereas A and C do not have the complement. Therefore, here in the max term, they will be 0, and we have the equivalent decimal as 10. Again, you have to apply that 8421. Here that fourth variable is not there, only three variables are there. So we have to take it as 421. Similarly, the second term is A, B bar, C bar, which is 011. This is binary and the equivalent is 3. Equivalent decimal is 3. So this has 1 and this is weightage as 2, 2 plus 1 is 3. And the third one is A bar, B bar, C, which is equal to 110. The equivalent decimal is 10. The max term list is now T is equal to F of the function of ABC, which is equal to, I told you max term list is represented by pi. And we have three terms in the list. The first one is second, third and sixth. This is the max term list. Moving further, we have one more example. Express the following POS equation in a max term list. You have to follow the same procedure. Instead of three variables, we have four variables here. Let us solve this. The first term is B bar C or D. This is equal to, this is 0, 1, 0, 0 in binary. Again, you apply 8421 formula. So this is 4 decimal. Similarly, for the next one, A, B bar, C, D bar, this is equal to 0, 1, 0, 1 binary. Base 10. This is 1 at the 4th position, weightage is 4 and this is 1, so 4 plus 1 is 5. Similarly for A bar B C D is equal to, we have 1, 0, 0 in binary, in decimal it is 10. For the next one, A bar B bar C D, it is 1, 1, 0, 0 in binary, 12 in decimal. Next term is A bar B C bar D. This is equal to 1010 in binary, in decimal it is 10. And the last term is A bar B bar C bar D. In binary it is 1110 base 2 and in decimal it is 14. Because these three are ones, 8 plus 4 plus 2, 12 plus 2 is 14. So we have this as the least of the max term. How do we write the max term list? Max term list can now be written as J is equal to F of A, B, C, D, which is equal to pi. It is represented as pi. In order, if you write 4, then 5, then 8, then 10, finally 12 and 14. So this is the max term list of the given expression. So you should know this because the same thing is being used into the Carnot map. Now write the min term and the max term numerical list for the following truth table. What we have, inputs as x, y, z and output as A and A bar. What we should write? Min term and the max term numerical list. So when we have to write the min term and the max term numerical list, for min term we need to consider ones into the output column. There are two output columns. The first output column is A and the second output column is A bar. So here we have 2, 1, 2 and 3 ones. With respect to this, we can write it as SOP equation. SOP is sum of product equation for output A. That is, A is equal to F of, it is a function of three variables x, y, z, and since it is a min term list, it has to be sigma. We get it as 2, 4 and 5. Because this is 2, this is 4 and this is 5. Similarly, SOP equation for A bar output. How do we write this? A bar is equal to F of x, y, z, which is equal to sigma of, how many ones are there? 1, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So write the equivalent decimal of this. We get it as 0, this is 0 and this is 1. The next one is 3. Next is 6 and 7. 3, 6, 7. Similarly, we have to write POS equation for both A and A bar. POS equation for A, we get it as A is equal to F, X, Y, Z, which is equal to pi of, for POS equation we need to consider 0. So all the zeros in the output column are to be considered, and that we get it as 0, 1, 3, 6, 7, and POS equation for A bar, that is A bar is equal to f of x, y, z, which is equal to pi of 2, 4, 5. So thus we can write SOP and POS equation when the truth table is given. Let me go to the document. We have solved this problem. So till now we have studied how to convert into the canonical min term and the max term expression and how to write the min term and the max term list. So this everything is used into the further study or further when we go for the Carnot map or when we go for the Quinn-McCluskey technique. So we will continue in the next session. Thank you.